Welcome back to our proactive London newsroom, and I'm talking to Dr. Tom Becker now. He's the CEO of Iofina, and a very good day to you, Tom. How are things?
Things are well, thanks.
Good to have you back on. It is your interims. They're out, and you are out there explaining the good news to everybody. So perhaps you can tell us a bit about how the first half was.
Yeah, the first half was another great first half of the year. Record revenues in EBITDA for a first half for Iofina, $24.3 million in sales and just under $6 million in EBITDA. So we're performing well as an organization and are continuing to execute our business plans. We also, during the period, got iodine up and running, had some water flowing through the plant, and it's now producing iodine. So we're very excited on the first half of the year that we continue to execute our business plans and even our growth plans, and are just performing well as an organization.
Thank you, Tom. So that's obviously what you did, but tell us a bit more about how you managed it.
Yeah, so we managed to have a good first half of the year in a number of ways. We've executed our production at our legacy plants. We had a small year-on-year growth at those particular plants. We continue to perform well as an organization on the Iofina chemical side and produced various add-on compounds. And, we just had a good first half of the year compared to what we've had in the past. We'll continue to grow our operations by adding new iodine plants and new products at our Iofina chemical plant. So really pleased for the first half of the year. And, we were also aided by continued high iodine prices, which we expect to also see within the second half of this year as well.
So plant number 10, perhaps you could give us a bit of an update there. And I even saw in the RNS some talk about number 11 even as well.
Yeah. So as an organization, from 2021 levels, we expect to be able to continue to add to our iodine production and likely double that production in the next 2 to 4 years. And plants like IO9, IO10, 11 will be the catalyst for us to do that. So we have IO9 online right now producing iodine. We believe we're very close to being able to sign an IO10. And once that's signed, it will be in a similar area of IO9 and continue to grow a new core area of iodine production for Iofina. But, we're not going to stop there. We have negotiations at various sites for an IO11 plants beyond there, not only in Oklahoma, but potentially in other areas around the United States. So we're very excited about the future of Iofina, and we continue to make progress as an organization.
It feels like every time you come on to speak to us at Proactive, Tom, that it's very similar in story, a positive 6 months and then another plant expecting to be brought online. Are you just going to be rinsing and repeating until the strategy stops working?
Well, I think we have some other, we'll be doing the added growth of adding what we know and doing it well. So we've proven ourselves with these Iofina plants that we can produce iodine at low prices and continue to add on this growth. So we'll be continuing to do that. But we do have some other projects in place, not only at Iofina Chemical to create new value-added products, but also on the Iofina resource side of, what other ways in the future can we isolate iodine, whether it's through smaller plants, whether it's through different areas, or whether it's through different types of partnerships, or even drilling our own brine well. So those are all things that are long-term things that we're looking at, but we are definitely focused on building the Iofina plants on a continual basis here moving forward.
All understood. And just finally, Tom, is there anything else you'd like to add today while we've got you here in front of our investor audience?
No, I think from a Iofina standpoint, we're going to continue to build these iodine plants. We're going to continue to add some other value to the organization. We've made some hires here recently on the sales and marketing side to try to get into other markets for certain iodine-based products and other non-iodine-based products that maybe we didn't have access to before. So we're investing in those kind of areas. We also invested in our geology team to know where iodine is and where other things are. So we're going to continue to invest in our group. So as we continue to grow, we have the resources in place to not just grow the business as we are now, but also look at other ways to grow the business from a sales and marketing and geological standpoint. So very excited about the future of Iofina.
Very best of luck with it all, Tom. And thank you very much indeed for your time today.
Appreciate it. Thank you.